This video outlines the types of stair structures available in the Stair Settings dialog of ARCHICAD. If we activate the Stair Settings dialog, we will find a hierarchical tree structure of stair sub-elements on the left pane. The Structure page contains settings that affect how the structure part of the stair is generated. Underneath it in the tree structure, you will find settings pages for flights and landings. By unchecking and checking the Structure checkbox of the Structure page, you can hide or show the structure or the stair, respectively. In the Flight Structure field, you can specify the type of structure for your stair flights. The four possible options are monolithic, beam, cantilevered, and stringers only. A preview picture is generated to the right of the checkbox, continuously updating with each modification. The stringers only option, when selected, will have the stringer left and stringer right checkboxes below the flight structure field checked. This will cause stringers to be generated on both sides of the stair flight. When any of the first three options is selected, it is also possible to check either or both stringer checkboxes to generate stringers as part of the flight structure. In the Landing Structure field, you can similarly specify the type of structure for your stair landings. The same four options of monolithic, beam, cantilevered, and stringers only are available here as well, with stringers behaving in the same way as flight structure. When the monolithic option is selected for the flight, the monolithic flight page is displayed in the tree structure on the left. Four different support shape options are available for monolithic flights. With the first option, the monolithic flight will have a smooth bottom with a constant structural thickness, the value of which you can specify. With the second option, the monolithic flight will have a stepped bottom. Two fields are available to specify the thickness of the horizontal and vertical segments of this stepped structure, respectively. With the third option, the monolithic flight will have a smooth bottom with a variable structural thickness. Two fields are available to specify the structural thickness at the flight's top and bottom, respectively. With the fourth option, the monolithic flight will have a horizontal bottom. Here you can specify a value of how much the bottom of the structure is offset from the stair baseline. When the monolithic option is selected for the landing, the monolithic landing page is displayed in the tree structure on the left. It's similar to the monolithic flight page, but it offers only a single option for the geometry and a field where you can specify the thickness of the landing structure. Both monolithic pages offer settings for the cut surfaces, outlines, building material, and surface overrides for the flight and landing. Additionally, you can check the Uniform Flight and Landing Attributes checkbox, which will make sure that any change you make to monolithic flight components will be automatically applied to the monolithic landing components as well, and vice versa. When the beam option is selected for the flight, the beam flight page is displayed in the tree structure on the left. Two different support shape options are available for beam flights. With the first option, the beam flight will have a smooth bottom with a constant beam thickness, the value of which you can specify. ARCHICAD's non-monolithic stair structures, such as beams, cantilevers, and stringers, are all created using GDL sub-elements, just like treads and risers. There are several GDL objects available for each beam support shape. The available GDL objects for the smooth bottom option are flight beam, open stringer, and profiled flight beam. Each of them offers many parameters and geometry options. For example, in the case of the flight beam 21 object, you can specify the shape of the flight beams, their building material, the number of beams to be placed, the width and height of the beams, and specify the exact position of each flight beam. You may also place tread plates, secondary supports, end plates at top, and end plates at bottom, as well as control the 3D representation and building materials and surfaces of flight beams. With the second support shape option, the beam flight will be a stepped beam, with both horizontal and vertical segments having a constant thickness, the value of which you can specify. The stepped flight beam 21 object parameters and options are very similar to those offered by the flight beam 21 object. When the beam option is selected for the landing, the beam landing page is displayed in the tree structure on the left. Several GDL objects offering various geometric solutions are available for beam landings, such as landing beam, landing frame, profiled landing beam, and profiled landing frame. For example, with the landing beam 21 object, you can specify the shape of the landing beams, their building material, the number of beams to be placed, the width and height of beams, and specify the exact position of each flight beam. Additionally, landing beams can be placed in various geometries, including the following: follow center line, follow center line expand segments to boundary, from lead and trail end of boundary, and custom. The custom option is like the from lead and trail end of boundary, the difference being that you can specify and configure up to 5 parallel beams instead of 1. Yet another option is the ability to place additional beams that follow the edges of the landing. After secondary beams are enabled, you can edit the stair and place beam to the lead end and trail end of the landing, and at each segment of the landing polygon as well. After placement, the lengths of these additional beams can be modified graphically to achieve the exact 3D look needed. When the cantilevered option is selected for the flight, the cantilevered flight page is displayed in the tree structure on the left. There are multiple GDL objects available, including cantilevered flight block, cantilevered flight bracket, cantilever flight profiled, flight metal pan, and flight metal plate. Each type has multiple parameter and geometry options. For example, with the cantilevered flight block object, you can generate wall fixings into the left, right, or both sides of the flight. You can set the geometry of the block, as well as set the 3D representation and building materials and surfaces options for the cantilevers. When the cantilevered option is selected for the landing, the cantilevered landing page is displayed in the tree structure on the left. Just as in the case of flights, there are multiple GDL objects available, including cantilevered landing block, cantilevered landing bracket, cantilevered landing profiled, landing metal pan, and landing metal plate, each with its own set of parameters and geometry options. When the stringers only option is selected for the flight, The stringer left and stringer right checkboxes become checked under the flight structure field, and the stringer's flight page is displayed in the tree structure on the left. On the stringer's flight page, you can specify to have uniform stringers on left and right by checking the checkbox at the top of the page. Or, you can specify both sides separately using the Select Stringer to Edit field. Two support shapes are available for stringers. The first has a constant thickness. You can set the width and height of the stringer, plus its height above treads, the value of which can be specified either perpendicularly or vertically. Flight stringers are also GDL objects. You can set the width and height of the stringer, plus its height above treads. You can choose from several GDL objects, such as flight stringer or profiled flight stringer. They both have their own set of parameters and geometry options, and by using these, you can set the shape of the stringer, set its building materials, add end plates at top and bottom, and so on. The other available support shape is the stepped option. The stepped flight stringer object has similar settings, width and height of the stringer, and height above treads. Additionally, you can set the shape of the stringer, set its building materials, add end plates at top and bottom, and so on. Stringers can be added to flights not only as the sole structure, but also as additional structures to any of the other three flight structure types. When any of the three structure types are selected for flights, check the stringer left or stringer right checkboxes below the flight structure field to add a stringer to the left or right of the flight, respectively. The stringer's flight page is displayed in the tree structure on the left, and you can specify stringer options as discussed earlier. When the stringer's only option is selected for the landing, the stringer left and stringer right checkboxes become checked under the landing structure field, and the stringer's landing page is displayed in the tree structure on the left. On the stringer's landing page, you can specify to have uniform stringers on left and right by checking the checkbox at the top of the page. Or you can specify both sides separately using the Select Stringer to Edit field. Landing stringers have a constant width. You can set the width and height of the stringers, plus its height above landing value. Landing stringers are also generated using GDL objects. You can choose from several GDL objects, such as landing stringer or profiled landing stringer. As well, they both have their own set of parameters and geometry options, and by using these, for example, you can set the shape of the stringer, set its building materials, add end plates at the lead end and trail end of the landing, and so on. Similarly to flights, stringers can be added to landings not only as the sole structure, but also as additional structures to any of the other three landing structure types. When any of the three structure types are selected for landing, check the stringer left or stringer right checkboxes below the landing structure field to add a stringer to the left or right of the landing, respectively. One additional feature of the stair tool is the ability to split any flight structure into multiple parts and to unify flight structures split earlier. To split a flight structure, select the stair and click the Edit command to enter edit mode. Select the flight structure you want to split, then right-click and select the Split Stair Structure command of the context menu. By moving the cursor, select the position where you want to split the structure at. Graphical feedback will show you which riser will be used as the vertical splitting plane. Click with your mouse to split the stair structure into two. The stair structure will now be split into two, and you can select and set the structure type for each separate segment as needed. If at a later point you wish to undo the split operation, enter the edit mode again, then select the two adjacent segments that belong to the same stair flight structure. Right-click, and select the Unify Stair Structures command from the context menu. The two separate segments will be united into a single stair flight structure, and the structure settings of the lower segment will be applied to the resulting geometry. The structure of stairs is one of the most complex parts. It's composed of multiple sub-elements using GDL objects, and with the multitude of options available, you can model practically any stair structure you need in your architectural practice.